Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video we are going to see what is Tor and how we can install Tor browser. So Tor basically stands for the onion routing. It is just like an onion, like an onion have 7 layers, just like that only. Tor also creates a network for us to transmit our data in several layers, like from one node to another. The data will be first transmitted from our system and then it will be transmitted to some other system, then from that to another node and so on, and then it will reach to the destination. So the main concept of Tor was the anonymity. It helps us to be anonymous on the internet. As we visit any website on Google, that is just a surface internet, but apart from that there is dark web as well, where we don't have websites such as .com, .in, .us and like that. There all websites are in .onion. So let us see how we can install Tor. First let us open terminal. Let me zoom it. Now here type sudo bash, type the password. Now type apt install -y tor, then tor browser launcher. This -y is basically for, it just says that whatever steps is asking for yes or no, it will just simply give yes. So hit enter. So now it will begin starting Tor. So as it is now installed. Now let us check service Tor status. It is currently inactive. Now we can run it using service Tor start. Now let's check the status again. Yeah, it is active now. Now whatever website we will visit, that website will not know who is the actual user, so it will keeps us anonymous, because our request will be transmitted from node to node, like from our system to one node, then another and so on. Like if we are in India, our request will first go to some random country, some like US, then to Brazil and then to some other country and so on, and then it will reach to the destination URL which we try to hit. Suppose if I go to the browser, and type in youtube.com, here our request will not directly go to youtube.com, it will first go to some other nodes, and then several other nodes, and then finally it will reach to youtube.com. So Tor basically bounces our network from one node to another with several different IP addresses. Now you might be thinking that if that is happening, then it will also affect our internet speed. So yes, while we are using Tor, it definitely affects our internet speed to some good extent. So that's why we can also use VPN, but that should be a good VPN, otherwise it will reduce our speed a lot, our internet speed a lot. So let us run our Tor browser. So as we already run the Tor service, now we will type Tor browser launcher. It will download all the required packages, and as we have already started the Tor service, we don't need to start it again. But in Tor browser also we have the option to connect with the Tor, so we can do that also. So now it is downloaded and it is extracting all the files and installing. So Tor browser is required to visit Onion websites, which is not accessible from Chrome normal browser. Here we got the error. Tor browser bundle should not be run as root. So we will get out of the root. We will type exit. Now we will type Tor browser launcher. It will launch our Tor browser. So here is our Tor browser. It is recommended that to keep the Tor browser size as like this only, because by expanding the browser size also we can leak our information around the world, which we obviously don't want. We need to be anonymous, that's why we are using Tor. Now you'll click on connect. It will connect us to the Tor browser. Now this is the default Tor browser. So the default search engine is DuckDuckGo, as DuckDuckGo provide a kind of anonymity because it does not store any history or any browsing data or anything. Now we will visit Facebook Onion website. We will search for Facebook Onion. Here we can find Facebook official Onion site, as Facebook have already its own Onion website in the dark web that we can access through Tor browser. Here in the Wikipedia, we can see the URL. Now I will visit this URL, the Onion URL of Facebook. It is similar to original Facebook. So with normal browser we are on the surface internet only, and using Tor we can visit the dark side of the internet or the rest of the internet, commonly known as dark web, or you can also say deep web. There are lots of various other versions of internet. Now here you can see, this is the Facebook website, the official Facebook website. So there are plenty of Onion websites you can find on Tor browser. You can actually visit those websites. There are many illegal websites as well, such as for carding or for, like, as rumor says, for visiting the Red Room. And there are lots of illegal activities we can access through dark web or using the Tor web, Tor browser, to visit the dark web. But there are positive aspect also of the Tor. We can use it to make us anonymous, like if you are a whistleblower, it is very beneficial for whistleblowers who wants to hide their identity. So Tor was basically developed for US Navy for the communication purpose, as it provides the anonymity of the data transmission so that they can communicate with each other anonymously. But later on they realized that if only they will be communicating using Tor, then someone can easily know or track them. So that's why they made it publicly available, so that everyone can use Tor, and inside that their communication will also be anonymous, as all the data that are transmitting will be encrypted. So Tor basically provides some extent to anonymity. Furthermore, you can use VPN to stay more anonymous on the internet. If you like this video, please do hit the like button. And if you have any query or you want to suggest any video which you would like to see, you can mention it in the comment section, and subscribe to my channel for more such contents.